projects, you assigned the test to each of the developers, and you got, you get like an idea of how long each of the tasks take, they tell you?
Yeah, I follow up the whole project, that they, all the things are working and going on, yeah?
Nice.
You are talking about this, the software cycle development, and yes, in my last job, there we have a daily spare project and planning on Mondays, and we had sprints for 2 weeks, yeah. And final this 2 weeks, we usually did a retrospective and demo session for the development of this sprint. But now we have this. We have some of this session in this enterprise, in this company, because, like I said to you, here they are trying to change the mindset from the traditional companies to the AI companies, and absolutely, we are working on some AI practices, but just in the big project that I'm working right now, yeah. And we have dailies, and we have weeklies, but for example, we don't have retrospective sessions. Demo, yeah, we have demo. But another practice from the AI philosophy, we don't practice it yet.
Mm. And they have different testing of the applications. Do you have like a DevOps team that does the deployment?
Yeah, we have a QA team for testings, all about the UAT testings, and then for the production testing, and we have a team for development too. Yeah, we have the whole team in our company, yeah.
Nice. And do you really believe in innovation?
Yeah, I really believe in innovation, yeah. I've been working for in the technology industry around since 2 years, but so deep, working so deep in this industry. But I've been working in projects and innovation consulting for almost 6 years. That's why I believe in innovation. I believe that with innovation, you can change your company, not just inside your company. You can improve your company and get or bring your company to the next level. If you think with the continuous innovation, it's better if you think with this continuous innovation. It means that when you are trying to look in outside for your core business, if you are looking for new opportunities in different markets or maybe different products that maybe make your business bigger than before.
Yes, you must always innovate.
Yeah.
And what is the most difficult part of being a project manager?
Okay, what's the most difficult? For me, since I was a student, I've been thinking that the most difficult for project managers, there is to manage the people. Yeah, this I think the people are the key resource for anything, for everything, for a project, for your life, anything. And that's why when you are working with projects or with people, even in your job and in your life, you need to be so careful with the people. You need to know how you can talk with them. And if you talk with me, for example, in a good way, maybe this way, it's a different way for another guy. And you need to keep in mind this, like the skill, how you should manage the people, how you should do a feedback to your teams, how you need to from the for example the bad days, and that these days, for example, don't affect to your team, And that's why I think that the most difficult item in the life of the project managers, yeah, is the people management. And in the finance management too, I think.
Oh, do you prepare a budget?
Yeah.
Like the income and expenses?
Yeah. Usually, absolutely, almost one and a half years ago, I haven't done it. But for this job, now I think I will do it. I wish I would have to do it.
Because do you make sure that the work doesn't go over budget or something like this?
Yeah, because when you are project manager, you need to keep in mind a lot of things that you need to follow up. For example, the schedule, the scope, the risks, the issues that in the project could happen. But at the same time, you need to be so careful about the efficiency of the project, about the numbers, about the money. If you have a budget, for example, or something like this. That's why I think, yeah, this is another difficult part for us.
And you create different documents when you start the project, and then those documents change.
Yeah.
The documents change over maybe because certain things come up.
Yeah. You know about this topic. Yeah, because for example, usually in the projects, not about technology projects, not about software development. Usually the projects, for example, like public projects or a private project in another industry, usually the requirements of the project scope, these are like a delimited scopes or delimited requirements. But when you are working in the technology industry, no, it's no, it won't happen, never, because in this industry, all is so fast. You have like a different stakeholders. You have your team, and your team receive the requirements from the client, and the client could be internal client or external client, and these requirements could change any day. Today, the client, internal or external, could say to you, okay, I want to put this bottle here. And tomorrow, this client could say to you, no, I don't want this bottle here. I want this bottle there. And that's why I think, for example, this kind of things and the technologies, projects, or software development, the philosophy, the agile philosophy, it's so good because it helps you to manage it, to manage the chain, to form the chain. That's why I recommend the agile philosophy for the software development. The other project, they could be managed by the traditional PM, the project management.
Oh, like when the different requirements don't change, and like when it's not, when everything is very set into stone,
maybe then you can, the construction,
yes, in the waterfall, yes.
Yeah, for example, where my mom is a civil engineer, yeah, right, and she has usually applied for a public project. But this public project, this has in Spanish is it's terms and conditions, maybe. This document usually it won't change. It usually keep the scope, keep the requirements, and maybe that this project. That this can change, it's about overcost or maybe other people, or maybe things about the efficiency of the project, but not about the requirements. If you need to build a way, if you need to do a house, if you need to build a building, if you need to build a bridge, I don't know. The scope is the same, but maybe you can have some issues. It's about efficiency, but not about the requirements.
But usually in the software projects, the scope can change, or it can be because the client can look at the project and then they can see that it needs something that can be changed.
And the software is wrong? Yeah, because in the software development, you usually have to interact with the client. And you usually have a present or share with them your advance in the project. And anytime the client could say to you, no, I don't like it. Or maybe, oh, I found a better idea and I want to change. Yeah, it could happen in the software development. Yeah.
Yes. And do you think every company should prepare a budget for income and expenses?
Yeah. I think we have talked with Luis about this topic before, because to survive in the business life and in the business environment, you should keep attention or stay in look at the money and look at the budget if you want to survive in the business environment. Yeah, because you need to keep in mind where you want to go, when you can get the same numbers that you invest and your income to stay alive. And you need to keep your equilibrium in English. I forget it.
Balance.
Yeah, the same balance between your investment, your invest and your income. And then when you start to get more income than your invest, you need to have such a good business plan where you know where you go and where you need to invest, and then how you are thinking that you want to make your business big, for example. But I think one of the things, or one of the most important things in any company, is the finance area, because almost there, they are the over angels, yeah, to keep the company alive, yeah.
Yes, they have to keep the company alive.
Yeah, stay with the taxes, stay with the retentions, you know, about the government's statements. It's difficult, yeah. I really admire them.
Yes, and...
And you know, the worst part for them, I think, because I have done invoice in my jobs, for example, and it is so complicated, and it is so worried, because you always try to looking at each number and the invoice, trying to doesn't do any mistake there. And you always try to review, and oh, it's okay. Okay, the name, the bank, the number account, the numbers, or the codes, the taxes. I think it is so complicated.
Yes. And are you good at math?
Yeah, I really like it. I'm industrial engineering.
You are an engineer?
Yeah.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah, I'm industrial engineer and I love math. And Excel, Microsoft Excel.
How do you split up your time at work?
How do you what? Sorry?
How do you split up your time at work?
I don't understand you.
Like, how do you split up your time at work? Like, divide it.
Okay, yeah, I got it. Yeah, I hear you. Okay. It's how I split my time in my job, right? Yeah.
At work is.
Okay. My work, now my work is split like with different meetings. Like I said to you, I have a dailies about the project that I'm managing right now. And the other things or the other meetings, they're like a business meeting from another thing. Maybe I'm meeting with my boss, maybe I'm meeting with another teammate that need me or something like this. I have another weekly meetings booked per week, and it is already in my schedule. I start my day at 9 a.m. then until 12 midday, and then I start usually my second stage from 2 p.m. until 6 or maybe 7. It depends of the day. It's okay. It's up.
Yeah, that's good. And why is advertising important for a business?
I think it is important right now, yeah, but it depends on the industry of the company. Yeah. For example, advertising, when you say advertising, I'm thinking advertisement on the street, on the wall, or something like this. If you say to me advertisement, but in the social networks or something like this, it's different. Because right now, all the business, of the majority of the business, they are migrating to the, like the cloud, yeah. They are migrating to the cloud. And that's why I think this kind of advertisement in social networks and something like this, this has a really, really value for the business, for any business right now. But for example, advertising in the wall, in the street, like a physical advertising, I think it is going to be go down in the time.
Yes, everything is online, all the advertising.
Yeah.
And
it's the pandemic more, I think.
Do you have any questions for me about the development, software development?
About development? No, I think maybe, but you know about the topic. Which is your professional? Yeah, tell me a little bit more about you, because I just know your name, really. No more.
Yeah. I develop applications for different clients, and I am.
But you are.
I'm also going to school. I also go to school. I'm a full stack developer.
Okay, front and back end. So
yes.
So smart. Yeah.
Do you prefer something? I prefer the front end.
Yeah, it's easier, I think.
Yeah, I think that maybe it has some things that are easier, but sometimes it can be harder at times.
For example, if you ask me, I prefer the functional requirements, that it's better than the unfunctional requirements. That's why I think maybe, I don't know, I'm not sure, obviously, but maybe it's better to try with the front than with the back. Yeah, because in the back you can find the architecture, you can find all the rules.